In this video, I'm going to give you five things that your church's next camera needs to have. Welcome to the channel. My name is Evan DeDio. This is going to be a fairly quick video. If your church is looking for a camera, these are five things that that camera will need to have, especially for churches, for pastors, for people who just need a good camera. So let's go ahead and jump into the first thing that your camera needs to have as a church. Number one is good lighting. Now, wait a second, Evan. I thought we were talking about settings for the camera. I thought we were talking about, you know, we need a 500 millimeter lens with a 1.2 aperture, and we need ISO range from 100 to 65 million. Now, you need good lighting first. You could have a $30,000 camera, and if the lighting stinks, the video is going to look even worse. So first of all, you need good lighting, and I've done lots of videos on this channel about lighting, so make sure you visit the description where I talk about a lot of my favorite lights, the ones that I'm using right now actually to shoot this video, the Fovatech Studio Pro Lighting Kit. It's great. I'll leave a link down in the description below so you can go and check it out on Amazon and read some of the reviews. It is $309, as you can see there, for a two-pack. It comes with the stands, and then you can get the soft box. And it makes the light look really soft. It's very nice. I'm also testing out this new light that I have here that would be great for you too. It's a little more expensive for one light, but I'll leave that up to you whether or not you want to invest in something like that. So far for me, it's worth it. And in the description, I'll also link up a video review I did of a budget $60 LED RGB two-pack of lights. Now these things do all different kinds of colors, so that's what RGB means red, green, and blue. So it'll do all those colors, and it's $60 for two lights. So that might be something to look into too. But first of all, your church needs good lighting. Secondly, you need good autofocus. How many of you know pulling focus is fairly difficult to do, especially if it's not a very expensive camera with focus help? So you need to make sure you have good autofocus. Now, a certain camera line that does great at this, and I'm going to be sharing a couple camera ideas that might revolutionize your church at the end of this video that check all of these boxes. But Sony has some of the best autofocus out there. Now, if you're thinking about color, you want good color out of camera, Canon has some good dual pixel autofocus too. You don't need to know what that means. It's pretty good autofocus, but I think Sony has the best. It tracks your face. Like, this is a Sony camera right now. It tracks my face and my eye to make sure that my eye is in focus. So it has very good autofocus. Number three, though, let's move on to number three. Make sure it can live stream. Whether your church is live streaming now or not, you need to make sure that you can live stream in the future if you want to. So I have actually extensive videos on this. Again, I'll leave a link to a video right there. There's a little YouTube card popping up. You can watch my whole live streaming setup. It's a little longer video, but it is what you're seeing right here. This is what the live stream would look like. In fact, let me know what you think about this. Does this look good? Question of the day, does this setup look pretty good? I'm using a Sony camera, the Sony a6400. This is a little above $1,000 if you want to spend that much. But at the end, again, I'll be sharing a camera recommendation that's under $1,000 that comes with its own lens too. So again, stay tuned for that. But how does this setup look? I've got the $60 LED lights. You see those on the ground over there? Those are $60 for two lights. I've got the Fovatech lights right here. I've got an extra little ellipsoid, I think is what it's called right there. That's the setup. Let me know what you think. Also on a Sony a6400. Good camera in 4K with a Sigma 16mm f1.4. Pretty good setup using vMix as my streaming software. And again, that video that I linked below has all of my settings, everything that I use, so you can go deep into live streaming. And it talks about what you actually need to live stream, because you can't just connect a cable from your camera to your computer. It's not that simple. You need a capture card. And I talk more about that in that video, so be sure you watch that video. Next up, number four, is distance. What does this mean, Evan? Make sure that the camera can be pretty far away. Make sure that it can be right here. Maybe this is 2-3 feet from my face. Make sure you can do that and be far away. That way, no matter what scenario you're in, you've got it covered. You've got it handled. You can make sure you can follow your pastor while he's on stage, or if he's just sitting at his desk, it would work there too. So distance is important. And next up, make sure it has a mic jack. That way, if you want to plug in good audio, you know, I would say audio is 70% of video. That's a good bit. And maybe you're thinking, wait, what? I thought I needed 4K. No, audio is much more important than video. You could have terrible looking video, but if the audio is bad, then, I mean, think about it. Whenever you click on a video and the audio sounds like this, are you really going to stay and keep listening to that video? Not really. So make sure that the camera has a mic jack and then invest in a pretty good mic. You could spend $15 in a lavalier mic. That'll get you some better results. Or you could get something like this. This is a Zoom H5 handy recorder, and you can kind of talk into it like this. And you can use this mic setup if you want to, which again is talked about in my live streaming setup video. So make sure that it has a mic jack. Now, those are the five things that your church needs, your next camera needs to have, in my opinion. Now, these are some of the most important things. Make sure that you have good lighting, good autofocus, make sure it can live stream, make sure you can shoot from a distance, and make sure it has a mic jack. Now, this is a lot of things to handle, and you might be thinking, Evan, there are hundreds of cameras out there that have similar settings just like this. What camera should I choose? Well, first of all, let's talk about the one in your pocket, your phone, okay? Your phone works good in good lighting. It has great autofocus. It can live stream. Now, I put an X next to has a mic jack because some phones don't have a mic jack. Apple. And I also put an X next to be far away because the more you zoom in, the worse the quality gets. But it still marks, it still checks some of the boxes here that are important. Probably 3 out of 5, I would say, maybe. So your phone is a great option. But here is a camera recommendation that I think will solve all of your problems. It check marks all of the necessities that we need, the Sony ZV-1. This camera comes in around $750, depending on what deal you get. Maybe it's Christmas time where you're at or around the holidays, so you can get a pretty good deal. Probably $100 off is what they usually do. This has amazing autofocus. It is Sony, so it has great autofocus. It can live stream. It has an HDMI out, so you can watch my video to learn more about how to live stream with this camera. You can be far away. It has a great lens here. Let's see, I'm trying to read the numbers on it. I can't read it from here, but it's a great lens that can zoom in pretty far at an aperture of 1.8 to 2.8. So the background will be blurry, and you can shoot in lower light scenarios, and it has a mic jack on it. So, I mean, this camera checks all the boxes, and it's under $1,000. Now, something you might think, well, it doesn't, you can't change lenses out, which I agree that is kind of iffy for me because I am a videographer, but I would still like to get this camera because of how simple it is to use. If you're just a beginner at using cameras, this camera is great, and I'll leave a link to it in the description so you can go and read the reviews to it. But I think it'll solve all of your problems. It's a great live streaming camera. It has great colors, great autofocus. You won't have to worry about being out of focus. So I think the Sony ZV-1 is definitely worth taking a look at. But hey, my name is Evan DiDio. If this is your first time on the channel, thank you for visiting. It's great to see you on here. But yes, be sure to subscribe if you'd like to see future videos just like this one, where I'm bringing you gear tips under 10 minutes. I mean, come on, y'all. Media tips and tools for churches. I'm here to help. If you have any questions, put it in the comment section below. I'll see you in the next video. Peace.